So let's say you've got some websites that you need to access all the time. And sure, you can put them in your bookmarks or your favorites bar, but you want even easier access. There are ways to get links to web pages that are even outside of Safari. For instance, the simplest thing is to simply click and drag the link at the top. And notice I can drag it anywhere. I could drag it outside of Safari to the desktop here and drop it there, and I get this .weblook file. This will actually launch Safari and take me to that page. So I can quit Safari here and double click on this on my desktop and it will launch Safari, go right to that page. I could put this file anywhere. So I could put it in a folder somewhere or on the desktop, wherever it's convenient for me to get to it. And you get rid of it just like you do any file. I'll just drag it to the trash here. Here's another option. Say you want to put it in the dock. You can drag, and instead of dragging it to the desktop, you can drag to the right side of the dock. And I'll drop it right there, and you can see it appears right there in the dock. It works the same way. I quit Safari. If I click on this in the dock, it launches Safari and goes right to that web page. Now the dock can actually have folders in it as well. So let's create a new Finder window, and let's just go to my Documents folder, say, and I'm going to create a new folder there. So I'm never going to access it here, but I'm going to create a new folder called Links, and I'm going to drag that to the dock, to the right side of the dock there. And now I could put these same links in it. So I can drag this website here into Links, and it's going to create a weblook file there. I can do another one, and I'll put that in as well. Now I've got two in there. Let's do a third one. So I've got three of these web locations here. Let me quit Safari. And I've already got the folder added to Links there. So it's already in the dock. I can click on Links and it pops up here. I can have it appear different ways. So I can have it do as a fan, which is this. I can have it do as a grid, which is this. Or I can have it do a list, which is this. And I can click on any one of these and it will launch Safari and go right to it. So you can put a whole bunch of links here in the dock. And the handy thing is that Safari doesn't have to be running for you to actually go to these. So instead of the step of launching Safari and then using favorites, you can do it in one step. Now what would be awesome is if you could also put links to web pages in the menu bar here at the top. And there are some third-party apps that kind of play around with that idea. But there's no real straightforward way to do it. But there is one way to do it with just the stuff that's on your Mac. It's not going to put a website as its own icon, but it will give you a menu up here to access websites easily. The way to get to it is to run an app that you've got on your Mac already called Script Editor. So I'm going to hit Command Space for Spotlight and search for Script Editor. And I'm going to run it. So Script Editor is something where you can use to create Apple scripts. We're not going to use it to actually create any scripts. We're just going to use its preferences menu. So Script Editor Preferences, under General, has something called Script Menu. So Script Editor gives you access to Script Menu. I can turn it on and I get this little menu in the menu bar. And it's got all this stuff in here. These are computer scripts. If you don't want to use those or investigate those, you can just turn them off. So now it's just really simple here. And we'll quit Script Editor. So now all it is a little menu bar icon that allows you to access the Script Editor or access something called Scripts Folders. And there's three of them listed. Safari Scripts Folder is listed because Safari is running. User Scripts Folder and Computer Scripts Folder are things that are always going to be there. User only for that user account on your Mac. Computer for all the user accounts on your Mac. So probably you want to use User Scripts Folder. We'll open that up. And that's going to be this pretty empty folder except for an Applications folder there. That's where that Safari comes in. But we're not going to put anything in there. Instead, we're going to drag and drop links just as before into this folder. So now we've added two links in there. So this folder is for scripts, but these web location files will work there as well. So let's look here in the script menu. And now you can see those two links appear there. So we can close this folder. We can access it very easily again using Open Scripts Folder, User Scripts Folder, so we can add more stuff to it. We can quit Safari, and now in the menu bar we know we've got this Scripts icon here, and we can access any web page we want. It's going to open Safari and it's going to go right to that web page. So now you can do it as an icon on your desktop or in any folder. You can do it as a doc link or folder of doc links. And you can do it in the menu bar in the scripts menu. Thank you.